Hi, I'm Dawn Monroe. I've been working on a program about solving PDF problems. And if you have had some of those frustrations, I'm sure you're going to be interested in this. And I've made a lot of discoveries about how Canva can be utilized to make some really great PDFs or to access those PDFs. That's portable document formatting, which makes it accessible to all kinds of devices and easy to open on computers. So I'm going to start out and go ahead and share my screen and show you a few samples. So the first one is about creating a PDF and just adding some live links to that document. So that's what I've got here. I'm going to go ahead and show you. This is a speaker one sheet. It's a back and a front and back. Here, I'll show you here. There you go, two pages. And what I want to do, I've already set it up so that I clicked on different objects in the document and I have connected a linking website to it. All I did is copy and paste that website into this spot. And I did that with my picture. I sent to my about page, my certifications also go to my about page. And then I did a couple of cool things. Of course, down here, I linked my website. This QR code also links the website. So if they just click it, it works. But I did a couple things here. I linked to my Calendly page so they can set up a free appointment if they click that link. And then here I have loaded a document. You could put it on like Google Docs or wherever, and I've got a document loaded where you can go and download it from the web. It's through my website. So when I actually download this document, you'll see that I downloaded as a PDF, the highest quality they give me there, and I just hit download. That's all I have to do. Now, what I'll show you is when you open that up, let's just open it and see. This puts it in a browser, so I'm not opening it in Adobe Acrobat at this point. I'm just opening it on a browser. Anyone can open it on a browser. And look, when I point at these things, these are live links. If you look down here in the bottom left corner, when I'm pointing at those are active links. Those will go, which is what we want, right? We want people to link back to our websites, get our downloads, go to our calendar, send us an email, whatever it is, right? So we've got all those links working. So you can live link to your websites, all those things. Now, I made a more extensive one. This is a webinar catalog that I made, much bigger. This actually took me 3 days with Canva help to figure out why it wasn't working. I made a page that is basically a table of contents, and I wanted it to link to individual pages so you could search for the specific topic, and then you could jump down to that topic and read more about those webinar descriptions. So when I did that, I had initially 25 pages. Well, after 3 days with Canva help, I found out it has a limit of 20 pages only. So I pushed the limits. I brought it back down. I tweaked some things and added a couple things to share a page so I could get this to work. And it is now working. So I want to show you the downloaded version of this. And I do have it. Let's go here. Here it is. It's opened here in the in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. There's several versions of Acrobat. I'll make another one specific to Acrobat, but here you could see, let's go to my table of contents list. Let's say I want to find things about Microsoft Outlook, and then I can click on that. It's a live link. It takes me to the Outlook page in my document. And then I've got down at the bottom, I put a little icon and I linked that all back to my topic list page. So you could go to whichever one you wanted. Let's go to Word. There's my Word topics. There's my link back to the topic list. So everything's working great in there. Let me show you how to set it up. So back on my, this is working on it in Canva. What I had to do, let's go to this page. There we go. And what I did was simply select a phrase, and then I go to my ellipses there, and I was linking. I linked those, and you can actually pick to link to a specific page. I'm going to remove that so you can see it. I've gone to the trouble to name my pages. In a bigger document, that's important. And so there I go, Microsoft Outlook. It puts the page there, and then that becomes a live link. I did the same thing with the object. I did the linking, and then that is going to the topic list page, is what I had all of those do from the other pages. See, I put it at the bottom of every page, and that one is actually linking back to the topic list. So that's how it's working. And then when I download it, all that works automatically. I've got it all set up and it works great. It's amazing. I can save this and share it digitally. I can make a printed copy of it. All of those will work just great. Now, a couple of other things that I think you're going to find exciting that I have discovered as I was unveiling all these PDF problems was that I could actually create a form in my Canva and then take that form over to my Adobe and add in the fields that I need to capture. I can make a live form. Okay, I can get a signature. I can do all of that combining these two programs. So here, what I did, I'll just take you home and I'll show you. I just searched for forms. If you need a form, if you need like a workbook, an interactive workbook for pages, and I downloaded one so you'll see it, but I went to forms. You can find a form. Maybe you need something, you know, something to fill out, a photo release. I don't know what you need for your business, but you'll find a lot of great starting points here where you could select the form. And then once you've tweaked it, branded it, made all the changes you need, and you save it as a PDF, you can open it in Adobe Acrobat and then engage the form features to make it a live, fillable, awesome form. I want to show you, I did play with that a little bit. You could look at some workbooks, and I did download, let's see, I believe I did this one. I think it was this one, maybe with a few pages. No, it wasn't this one. It was, let's go back. Let's see what I've got on my home page. I played with a bunch of them, as you do when you're experimenting. Okay, here's the one. I did a workbook. I pulled down a workbook. This is a 6-page workbook that could be tweaked for your course, whatever you are building. And then here's like a reflection page. This could be something fillable that when you take it to a PDF, they could actually fill it and save it online. Wouldn't that be great? So I'm going to link how to do a PDF on the other side from Adobe Acrobat to follow up on this. Now I found something else, again, dealing with taking PDFs that are already created, bringing them into Canva, and then updating them with new stuff. So let's say you have an old file, you couldn't find the original. This is going to solve the problems. So you could actually go to import file. This is a fairly new one. It's still, they're still working out the kinks, but let me do, I brought in a few. This is an old one I had set up. Needs a little more work, needs more links and things in it. And so I'm bringing in the old PDF. Let's say I lost the original I had done in Word. And I'm going to be able to work on this and update it right here in my Canva. So fun. So amazing. Connecting two great, powerful programs together like this. So again, this is an old thing that I created initially. I did this in Word. Let's make it a little bigger. Now they're asking for feedback on these because this is still in a beta situation. The feedback I would give on this one, it brought in these little captures just fine. What I'm noticing is that my links are not set up. So I'll have to reestablish my links, but otherwise my graphics and things and the text chunks came in really well. Okay, so that's some good news. I'm gonna bring in another one just to show you. Let's say I'm putting together a recipe album for the family. And I've got a favorite recipe that I always get from allrecipes.com. Let's credit them. And there I've got the recipe. I'm going to open that one in Canva. And here it is coming in. This is just amazing how it's picking up all the pieces. So you know what? I could copy and paste this into my family album. I'm going to keep all the, you know, all recipes, and down here they've even got the link for it. So I would keep all of that in there, but I'm going to include this in the favorite recipes that I'm gathering up to share with my family. So anyway, look, all of these are your little chunks, right? You can work with these text chunks. You know how to do that part. So you're ready to go. You're ready to play with something. I hope you've enjoyed these Canva to PDF and PDF to Canva things that I've been able to discover for you. Be sure to subscribe and like and look for other videos. I've got videos on all kinds of content. Have a great day. Thanks again.